Is the Sony Alpha NEX3. It is Sony's mirrorless camera. So now I'm going to attempt to actually demonstrate how this camera actually fares in terms of doing macro shots. So, you know, one of the initial things that I thought was that using a 16mm lens, the prime lens for this particular camera, Sony calls it the pancake lens, would be actually the most ideal in terms of taking macro shots. And surprisingly, that's not really true. So what we usually do on Gear 65 is that we use this camera. Even the beginning of this particular video, you actually saw it with this particular camera. And you know, what we usually do is that we bring devices really close up. So this, for example, this is the Motorola XT Quench XT3, an Android phone that we're testing right now. We usually bring it about really close like this, right, to show you the buttons and all that, because that's what we do. We want to show you as much detail as possible. And we found out it's not actually possible with this particular camera. So for example, let me just try and get it to focus as close as I can. And this is the closest I can actually get the pancake lens to actually get to. And, you know, I can't actually bring it close up like this to show you the buttons because, you know, the camera just won't focus that close. So that's actually particularly surprising. But of course, you can see how beautifully it does the defocusing. And even if I get it to focus onto, say, the Zakti camera right here, you can actually feel a little bit of the sense of that much better compared to a normal camera. Let's say this camera, by the way, itself, if I were to shoot with this camera, you wouldn't be able to feel that sense of depth as much as you would on a camera with an interchangeable lens. So now let's switch over to the 1855 lens and let me just demonstrate to you how else you can actually do macro shots. And so now I'm on the 1855mm lens, and surprisingly, the right way to do really close up macros is actually to take the 1855 lens and zoom right in. So I'm just gonna zoom right into the 16mm lens, and you can see that I can actually get the device to be much closer right now, so I get it to focus here. And that's how I would actually be able to show you, say, the buttons on this particular camera. So let me just try and bring it, see how close can I actually get it to go. And see, right here, you can actually see the buttons really clearly, just like we usually do on Gear 65. You know, you can see the camera lens, the printing, you can see it really well. You know, you can see the fingerprints, the dust, and the scratch on the screen protector, the plastic film that's on this particular camera itself. So, you know, it's actually possible as well. So surprisingly, if you want to do really close-up macros, you might want to consider getting the camera with the 1855mm lens rather than the 16mm lens. So to do macro shots that are as close as this. So the prime lens is actually much better in terms of taking portrait cameras, but if you want to do really close macros, this is the lens that you might want to actually find. And once again, you know, you can actually feel that sense of depth right there. So here's another test that I actually want to do, which is this is what we usually do in broadcasts, in professional camera. What we usually do is we zoom it into the extreme, right? Get it to focus as sharp as possible, and zoom it out. And so as you can see, it works quite well. So you know, if you at this distance, it's hard to tell, of course, all right. But you know, even though you know zooming in and out, it still keeps it in focus. So you know, the lens is well calibrated. So I'm on manual focus once again, and so now maybe it's a good chance for me to show you what happens if I switch it to autofocus. So now the camera is on autofocus. So if I shift it outwards like this, you can see that it is actually still on focus. And if I bring it much closer in, okay, and I zoom it in, it's still going to take a while before it actually tries autofocus itself. So the only way you can do that, to force it to get to speed that up. Okay, so there you go. So that's the amount of time it took to refocus itself. So let me just shift it backwards again a little bit. Right now it's relying on autofocus completely. So let me just put the lens here. So it's going to take it's not as fast as you would be able to do if you are on manual focus, obviously. But it does a relatively good job. Okay? And one other thing that you can actually do, let's say I'm just going to put that, right, let me just bring it right close right here. You can actually hit the shutter key and it will try to force itself to autofocus. And unlike the Sanyo Zakti HD, which we usually used, you can't actually lock the autofocus. So that's a feature that's usually not on cameras anyway. So that's something that's pretty unique for the Sanyo camera. But that's one thing that you might want to take note in case you're someone like me who, you know, actually own this particular camera. So this is how the autofocusing is working right now. You know, it's very extreme moving of distance in terms of depth, so it takes a little bit longer, but you can see that, you know, if you're just going to move the object slowly, it's actually doing quite a alright job, considering that this is actually a mirrorless interchangeable lens camera. And try and hear the sound of the autofocus servo. So that's it, this is the autofocus test. As my macro test as well, and the lens that I'm currently using is the 18-55, and I'm holding the 16mm prime lens, pancake lens, by the Sony, for the Sony Alpha NEX 3 as well as the NEX 5, filming at 720p HD.